Let's now head to the press conference of the Banco Central ng Pilipinas regarding the off-cycle rates. Let's listen
in. 25 basis points to 6.5% effective tomorrow, 27 October 2023. Accordingly, the interest rates on the overnight deposit and lending facilities will be set to 6% and 7% respectively. The Monetary Board recognized the need for this urgent monetary action to prevent supply-side price pressures from inducing additional second-round effects and from further dislodging inflation expectations. The latest baseline projections point to an elevated inflation path over the policy horizon as upside risks continue to manifest. Before today's monetary policy action, the staff risk-adjusted forecast for 2024 was 4.7% from 4.3% previously. The staff, this is well above the government's target range. At the same time, second round effects have broadened, including transportation fare increases and minimum wage adjustments. Inflation expectations have risen sharply, highlighting the risk of further second round effects. The balance of risks to the inflation outlook still leans significantly toward the upside, due mainly to the potential impact of higher transport charges, electricity rates, international oil prices, and minimum wage adjustments in areas outside the national capital region. Meanwhile, the effect of a weaker than expected global recovery, as well as government measures to mitigate the effects of El Niño weather conditions, could temper inflationary impulses. On the output side, recent domestic indicators point to dissipating pent-up demand in the near term. Nevertheless, the country's medium-term growth prospects remain largely intact. The Monetary Board is closely monitoring the impact of the increased interest rates as these work their way through the economy. The Monetary Board also continues to support fiscal efforts to sustain growth through more rapid program spending, as well as non-monetary interventions to address persistent supply-side pressures on prices. The Monetary Board supports the economic manager's timely efforts to extend the effectivity of EO10 beyond 2023, as well as to reform the Tariff and Customs Code. Looking ahead, the Monetary Board deems it necessary to keep monetary policy settings tighter for longer until inflationary expectations are better anchored and a sustained downward trend in inflation becomes evident. In this regard, the Monetary Board will continue to be guided by incoming data. The BSP is prepared for follow-through monetary policy action as necessary to bring inflation back to a target consistent path in keeping with its price stability mandate. Thank you.
Thank you, Governor. We will now proceed to questions from our media friends.
I will take a few questions and then I will leave it to Deputy Governor Francis Dakila and to Assistant Governor Lucy Cut, to answer the harder questions.
Thank you, Governor. Before asking your question, please identify yourself and your media organization. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Governor. This is Keisha from Business World. Will the Monetary Board still meet on November 16? And earlier you said that a 25 basis point hike is possible next month. So is this still on the pipeline? What factors are you looking at to resume or continue tightening on November 16?
We will meet again on November 16 as scheduled. We will look at incoming data. Early in November, there's going to be a new CPI number. and we will look at other indicators of demand. GDP, the Q3 GDP will come out also before the 16th. So we will have additional data to consider, and then we will decide.
Thank you, Governor. Next question, please. Yes.
Gov, good afternoon. Mikael Flores of Reuters. Gov, in your statement, you mentioned that the Monetary Board recognizes the need for urgent monetary action to prevent supply-side pressures from inducing second-round effects. From the meeting last month, you mentioned that inflation is expected to ease back towards the target path in the fourth quarter. Is that still the case? Or
That's no longer the case. We don't think that will happen. In fact, I think from March to July next year, the headline inflation will very likely be above 4%.
So from March to July next year, it will still be above target next year?
Yes, that's what our model says.
When do you expect then, Gov, for inflation to return back to the 2 to 4% target? Around August of next year?
Yeah, I think beyond July, it will head back towards the middle of the target range, so somewhere around 3%, and we'll stay around that region for the rest of the year, for the rest of 2024. Beyond July, yeah. July starts to come down.
Thank you, Governor.
Thank you, Gov.
Thank you.
Next question, please.
Hi, Gov. Lawrence Akawili from Philippine Stars.
Yes.
Gov, just a clarification. So you're no longer expecting inflation to return to the target within the year?
No, we're not expecting that anymore. No.
So do you have an estimate for the third quarter GDP?
We have an estimate for Q3 GDP. It's going to be somewhat higher than Q2, but 4.5 or? I remember around 4.5%. So some recovery from Q2.
Thank you, Gov. Next question. Yes.
Hello. Good afternoon, Governor. I'm Cliff Benson from Bloomberg. Governor, will you consider a rate hike in the November meeting, and under what circumstances will you consider a rate hike?
We will consider it if things are worse than we thought. We're hoping that the data are more are nicer to us, but if not, then we will have to consider a further rate hike.
Thank you, Governor. Follow up.
I want to kind of provide your other Governor, in terms of the GDP that appears to be.
Yes.
What kind of
the tightening, as far as we can tell, has not really affected growth prospects. GDP seems to be slowing down, GDP growth slowing down because of pent-up demand waning. We kind of tell this from looking at Google Trends and the words that are used to describe output, growth, demand. So the words that are used tend to be about travel, about shopping. So that we associate with pent-up demand. And that seems to be waning.
Thank you, Governor. Last question.
Governor, you mentioned that inflation will still be above target around second half next year. Do you think we can still reach our growth targets for 2024?
So inflation will be above target first half of next year. Our growth targets are lower than before, but that seems to be partly because of the slowdown in global demand and also the disappearance of pent-up demand. But we're watching that very closely. We don't want tight monetary policy to affect negatively our growth prospects.
Thank you, Governor. We have a last question.
Governor, just maybe on hindsight or looking back, should you have raised the interest rate in September when there were already clear indications that you might be breached the 2024 target? I mean,
in my view, yes. I think we fell a little bit behind. That's the reason for this effort to catch up. I don't know if the rest of the monetary board agrees with that, but we didn't look closely enough at expectations. We have various measures of expectations, and one of them that was very striking this time was our consumer, our household expectation survey. About 92% of consumers think that in the next 12 months, inflation will be above 4%. It's similar for expectations by firms. That's very worrisome to us because, as you know, monetary policy cannot control supply-side price shocks, but it can serve to break the link between those supply-side shocks and expectations, and also the link between those supply-side shocks and second-round effects, including, for example, transportation fare hikes and minimum wage increases. So that's what we worry about. That's what we focus on.
Thank you. Thank you very much,
Thank
Governor.
You.
Thank you, Governor. We acknowledge the question from Ted Cordero, and we think it was already responded to by the Governor earlier. This ends our press briefing this afternoon. We thank everyone for joining us, our media friends, the Governor, Deputy Governor Dakila, Senior Assistant Governor Sikat, and Officer in Charge Lapid. We also thank those who are watching us live on Facebook for their time and attention this afternoon. Maraming salamat po.
All right, there you go. The Banco Central ng Pilipinas announces an off-cycle rate of 25 basis points. That's effective today. That's plus 25 BPS, citing the need for urgent action to prevent further supply-side triggered inflation. They're seeing upside risks still prevailing. The Banco Central Governor, Ely Remolona, was talking about second-round effects broadening in terms of transport and wage increases, which is believed to be happening soon and very sharp. Now, the outlook, the upside from oil price increases, power rate hikes, transportation and wages, even beyond the National Capital Region, is something to closely monitor. The BSP also saying weathering a global recovery is still a concern because the difficulties are still there and the disparity in terms of pent-up demand also triggering more inflationary risks. Now, the question is, November 16, the BSP is supposed to meet for the regular Monetary Board policy meeting. They will still do that. And the Banco Central Governor was saying they will still be data dependent, which means to say inflation numbers will be out by then. And that will be the basis for another policy rate increase. So possibly there is another one before the year ends. Now, the Banco Central is also cognizant of the fact that it will be a scenario of tighter for longer, and they will still be data guided in terms of their future actions.